All right, everyone, Isa here. I'm the rug colorist and wanted to show you guys the unpacking of the Diebold airbrush. So the airbrush holds a gallon of dyes and it comes with a 10-foot hose. That's the air hose that you will be using with the air compressor. And that's the box that the air compressor comes in. Take a look at that, that's a beauty. Very small, very compact, easy to take around with you to your carpet and rug dyeing jobs. So now you put the air hose into the compressor and then you attach the other end to the actual airbrush. And that's going to be at the bottom of the airbrush. And then you can go ahead and attach the solution hose, which is on the side of the airbrush. And last thing to do is to plug the air compressor in. Now just open the airbrush container. And before the first use, you want to add water. So this is just clear water. And we're going to prime the Diebold airbrush to get rid of any air bubbles that might be on the solution hose. And this will only take a few minutes. So you notice once you turn the air compressor on, go ahead and press down the button on the top of the air hose, the airbrush. And as you press it down, there will be air coming out. And when you pull it back, there will be the solution coming out when it is fully primed. But before we do that, we want to go ahead and open the back of the airbrush and unscrew that back part and pull the middle part back. And then screw back on. And what we're doing there is opening up the actual airbrush, the opening of the airbrush, so that we can prime this faster. Okay, so as I'm pressing the nozzle there, I can see that the water is having a difficult time getting to the airbrush. So we're going to actually have to siphon the water through the hose to get it going. So I can see some air bubbles. So I tighten that up, make sure that there's no air coming in. And so now I'm proceeding to siphoning the water. And you just want to pull it about halfway. Now this is clean water, but I don't recommend that you drink this water. So don't siphon it all the way to your mouth, just about halfway. And once that's done, I lower the airbrush and I proceed to spray, and there's the water coming through. And I just want to spray enough until all the air bubbles are out. And for that, you need to spray it for about 30 seconds, maybe. And you can see that water is coming through. So now I have my dye solution inside of a container, which is inside of the dye container. And I'm turning the air compressor on. And I'm going to proceed to test out the airbrush to make sure that the dyes are coming through. And here we see the dyes flowing, going through the hose. And I'm continuing to press the airbrush button, the nozzle on the top of the airbrush, until the dye goes all the way through the dye solution hose. Once that's done, I want to go ahead and unscrew that knob at the end, press the metal piece all the way through, but gently, and then screw that nozzle in the back. And at this point, you can actually go ahead and put the backing of the airbrush back on. And that nozzle in the back there, the little screw in the back, is actually used to adjust the opening of the airbrush. So it's a very nice, fine control that we have in this dye bolt airbrush. And there I'm just testing it out on this rug, this piece of scrap. And the dye is coming out nicely. Now, if you've never tried airbrushing a rug, this is the most fun that you can have. Literally, I feel like I'm getting paid for having fun. I absolutely love airbrushing rugs. So now I'm going to proceed to airbrush a sun-faded rug. I have already calculated the color formula. So you see where that area is faded. I am airbrushing the top so it matches the bottom. And if you want to learn how to airbrush a rug, we actually have a class coming up on August 19th, which is for the basic spot dyeing training. And then on August 20th, we have an airbrush training for those of you who want to learn how to dye rugs, how to dye multicolor, multi-pattern carpets. And if you want to find out more information about this, you just go to www.dyeboldacademy.com. And if you're interested in getting an airbrush, you can find that at the dyeboldstore.com. And there we have it. It's a perfect match. I always check the back to see what the color should be on the front. So that's what I'm doing there. If you have any questions, you know where to find me on Facebook. I am Isa, the Rug Colorist. You can also find the upcoming classes coming up on Facebook at Dyebold Academy page, or also on dyeboldacademy.com.